stats is the second problem for chapter 3, free response practice. And in this from 2015, number 5, it's about heights versus arm spans. And as you would expect, the people with more longer arm spans also are taller, shorter arm spans are shorter, but there's a lot of scatter. They want us to describe the relationship first. Remember when they say to describe a scatter plot, we're thinking of four things. We're thinking of dots. So I'm going to talk about all of those four things, and then I'm going to put it in context. So D is direction, and this is definitely positive. Outliers? I don't see any outliers. I see everything kind of following this pattern, so I'm going to say none. And you actually don't have to mention that if you don't see any. F is for form, and it is not curved, it is linear. And S is for strength, which could be strong, moderate, or weak. This is kind of scattered. I'm going to call it moderate. And it's kind of in between strong and weak. Definitely positive, though. So that's why it's not weak. So the other thing we often require on this type of question is the context. So I'm going to write this in a sentence about arm span and height. So I'm going to say there is a moderate longitude linear relationship between arm span and height. And you could add another sentence if you want to, saying what I said at the beginning, that people that are taller have larger arm spans, and people that are shorter have smaller arm spans. That's the same as saying it's positive. So that is what you're expected to do. The rubric talks about having all of these plus context. Don't forget the context. All right, so then they say, here's the same scatter plot two more times with two different lines of fit on it. So this one is the least squares regression line, which they give you the equation. And then this is the line y equals x. So like the person with 64 height had 64 arm span, and that's why they're on the line. So y equals x is this one. And they want you to think about what you would use these two graphs for. So B, they're talking about categorizing people as square, tall rectangle, or short rectangle, which is a silly way to categorize people, right? Square just means their arm span is the same as their height. Like the width and the height are the same. That's kind of interesting. Tall rectangle is they are taller than their arm span, or the arm span is less than the height. And short rectangle is arm span is greater than the height. So they want you to think about which of these graphs would help us make this distinction between people. Would we be using the line of fit graph, or would we be using y equals x? And y equals x is actually the more useful one. So graph 2. Because if y equals x, those dots on the line are the square ones. So square would be, if it's on the line, I would put that as my explanation. I think I'm not going to write a complete sentence for my explanation, but you can if you want to. If you're above or below the line, that would tell you that you're a rectangle shape. And it's a little bit confusing because below the line means the height is bigger. And that would be the tall rectangle. And above the line means that the arm span is bigger than the height, and that would be the short rectangle. So if you thought it was the other way, I understand, but you have to really think about which direction is which. So below the line are the tall rectangles. We're going to use that to categorize these 12 seniors on the graph. So we're ignoring graph 1 for part B. We're just using graph 2, and I'm counting how many dots are on the line. There's 1, 2, 3 dots on the line. Tall rectangles are below the line, 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll just make them bigger instead of putting a dot underneath them. Short rectangles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's just counting the dots. By the way, I noticed that they made this problem really easy for the people grading by making it 3, 4, 5. That doesn't make it easier for you necessarily, because they planned these numbers so that it was easy for the people grading it to see if you were right. That's crazy. And all you had to do is write the numbers. That's all for part B, too. Part C says using the best model for prediction. Okay, so which one of these is the best model for prediction. It wouldn't be the y equals x model. It would be the least squares line. That's the whole point of the least squares line. The least squares regression line is the best model for prediction. So I'm going to write down the equation that they gave me up there. 11.74 plus 0.1847x. I'm going to plug in the height that they gave me, which is 61 inches. So multiply by 61, type it in your calculator. You know what? You don't need to see me type it in your calculator, do you? I'm just going to write the answer, which is 62.8467. And of course, you could round that a little bit if you wanted to. Inches. And you didn't have to do anything more than show work on this and give the answer. So the showing work is your justification, and we chose the, I guess the tricky part of this one is you had to choose the correct equation. You had to realize we're no longer looking at graph 2. Now we want graph 1, and we want the equation for it. But that's fine with it. But that's it for that one.